exciting. Kiana Yamott, the new Miss Hawaii USA 2022. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. I'm so excited to be here.
Oh, I can imagine. Excited just in general, too, for all the things that happened this weekend. Of course, we watched it. It was live here on KH12, your crowning moment. So tell us how you're feeling. What has it been like the last couple of days?
I still can't believe it happened. This is my first pageant. I've never experienced anything like it. I didn't know what to expect. All I know is I had a great time and I'm so lucky to be here.
Oh, wonderful. And lucky for the year ahead. I mean, yeah. I know the experience of competing in itself was so much fun. But what are your goals for this upcoming year?
My goal is to use Miss Hawaii USA's influence to promote women in STEM, particularly women in construction. We have made great strides in when medical students have our majority women. When I look at the job site, I'm often the only girl in the room. And I really want to promote women getting into that field.
Wonderful. And then, so professionally, you've worked as a civil and construction engineer. And I was talking about earlier to the viewers, I was saying that you had a great onstage question answer. So it was something along the lines of, because you're a big Back to the Future fan, right?
Huge.
So they asked what your favorite quote was, right? Mm-hmm. And then you answered and then changed it into the about your career. So can you tell us a little bit about that one?
Well, the line is, roads where we're going, we don't need roads. And civil engineers design public infrastructure, roads being one of them. So if we weren't to have that, I would be out of the job, and that's terrifying. But I do love those movies. So for me, it was a great line, and I'm glad I could throw a little bit of myself into it.
Yeah, that was perfect. I love how you transitioned to it. But talk a little bit about more of the projects that you have worked on.
So one of the most recognizable projects is H&L, the newest extension, Mauka. That's 12 new gates. Mm-hmm. So I always am getting people tagging me like, oh, look at Kiana's new terminal. And that's exciting for me. My latest project is a Sand Island wastewater treatment plant. Not as exciting for some people, but I'm really excited because it's the largest project our company has ever done in the Pacific. So I'm really, really excited to share that.
Very cool. Well, congratulations. I mean, that's making huge changes across the state. So very cool that you're a part of that. And speaking of changes, by the way, you look incredible. Everyone at home is thinking, wow. I mean, obviously you're gorgeous, have an awesome body. We saw you rocking the stage, working it in your swimsuit. But for this pageant, you lost 55 pounds. Mm-hmm. That's incredible. So tell us about that experience.
I, for so long, like a lot of people, made every excuse why I couldn't take care of myself, physically, mentally. I wanted to regain the confidence and feel like the athlete I was back in high school, because I was a wrestler, cheerleader, pole vaulter, and I used to have the energy to do all the things I wanted to do. When I gained all that weight, I made every excuse to, you know, to not work out, to not eat healthy. And now that I've lost all that weight, I have the energy to do the things. I can go snorkeling, I can go hiking. I love that I have the energy.
Wonderful. Okay, and I'm sure everyone's wanting to ask, mainly myself, how? What did you do? What's the secret, or what did you work on?
I started with going to group fitness classes, because for me, I was in athletics and I needed a coach to really guide me through it. So first I started going to group fitness, and then I got two gym memberships, and I invested in a personal trainer.
Okay.
Because I trust people who know what they're doing. I'm not an expert when it comes to fitness, but I'm very lucky I had somebody who taught me nutrition, who taught me my weightlifting and running and all that. So that's what I did. I just trusted the right people.
Well, perfect. Okay, good to know, and good tips. I gotta get some of those people's names from you.
Oh, absolutely.
And then you mentioned it's your first ever pageant. So incredible. Again, congratulations. But for those who are potentially interested in pageants, maybe don't know anything about them, what advice would you give?
To really enjoy the small moments. I have never done anything like this before. I've done athletics and competitions, but something like this where you get to really enjoy being with the other girls and learning about yourself and having the confidence to present your platforms or express how you feel about certain things. Just really step back and enjoy it, because it went by so fast, and I'm so grateful that I took all the selfies with the other contestants. I got to really watch what others were doing, and I I enjoyed it. Just sit back and enjoy it.
And you could tell. I feel like when you were on stage, you could just see that you were having so much fun. You looked absolutely amazing. Obviously did an incredible job.
Thank you.
Big congratulations, and we can't wait to see you compete on it, Miss USA. So good luck in your future endeavors as well.
Thank you.
And of course, we'll be talking to you a lot more as that process comes up a bit more too. And coming up a bit later here on Living 808, we're actually going to be talking to the very new Miss Hawaii Teen USA. So stay tuned for that. But thank you so much, Kiana, for joining us this morning, and congratulations.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much, Kiana. Excited, Kiana. You look amazing. And if you guys missed it, there's a rebroadcast this Saturday on our sister station, KHI. So make sure you guys tune in for that.